Look, this is what I'm talking about. You see the little kids? They're there all the time. Like, they're the only ones. You know, I understand they're little kids. I'll come back later, but still. So this is the spot that I come to when my roommate is in the room. Because this is exactly what I do. Look, I come in this bag. I put my laptop in the bag. Bring my laptop with me. I come get my microphone. Y'all don't believe me? This is exactly what I do. You know? Boom. Right? Throw the bag over there. We put the microphone where the pedals are. And my legs are surrounding it. So all the background... And we close this. We close this window. You guys thought I was joking when I actually do this. I actually do this. Close this window. We turn everything off. Right? Come bring the laptop here. You know, I want my own TV show slash talk show like Stephen A. Smith has. So, this is what I do, man. You know, and no one can say I don't work hard. You can't sit there and say I can't work hard. This is for everyone that says, oh, I don't have, you know, I don't, right now I'm not in the right situation. You know what the right situation is? You make the right situation. You know what I do? I come because I get a lot of cop trouble sometimes when I'm just sitting in my car, especially back in New York, but I didn't really do it in New York, just once or twice when my family was there. But here, I have a lot of cop trouble before. At least 5 or 6 times, cops came in like, what are you doing? I'm like, oh, I'm just, you know, talking on Skype or something, right? And I showed them my laptop and my mic, and they're like, oh, okay. You know, so to avoid that, what I do is I get my phone up, I turn this brightness all the way up, and I just put it here. And for anyone driving by, it looks like I'm just on the phone. You know? So that's that. This is for everyone that says, you know, I'm not in the right situation right now. I'm sweating like a mug already. I'm not in the right situation. You know, I have to wait until I can do this. I have to wait until, you know, I get this or I get this. Just do it. Just get up off your lazy ass and just do it, man. I'm so sick of people with all these damn excuses. Just do it, man. Just do it. And that Kevin Durant is no longer the second best player in the world. Now, how the hell is Kevin Durant not the second best player in the world? Here's the thing. You guys aren't into cars like me, but look at this MX-5, dude. Thing is clean. Damn. All right, yo, we're going through I'm scared as hell. Nah, I go through this like probably once a week, but it scares me. Look at this, I can't see. Look at this. Like I'm freaking aliens, dude. Yo, right now, my antenna is like crooked, you know, and it's freaking embarrassing as hell. You know what I mean? It's embarrassing as hell, man. But guys, look at this. Look what the bruh, look at that. I was rolling around with it fucking crooked. Look at this. Oh my gosh. That's so embarrassing. Look at that. This is so fucking embarrassing, dude. Look at this shit. I'm rolling around with my car like that. I can't, dude. I can't. That? Embarrassing. I gotta roll through the drive-thru with this.
Hi, can I be please?
Hi, can I just have a vanilla milkshake?
I'm sorry, you said one vanilla milkshake?
Yes, ma'am.
Is that all for you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, 276 for the first one, thank you.
Dude, look at this. Oh my gosh. Look at this. The whole car looks good. Until you get here. Look at this. What the? Oh my gosh. That's embarrassing, dude. Oh my gosh. I can't. I don't know how to fix it. The courts are open, so that's good. But oh my gosh. I know you guys are probably like, by the way, the milkshake was good. I know you guys are probably like, why the hell are you selling that, guys? I'm a car guy, you know. I love basketball and I love cars, you know. So when you see this, you know what I'm saying? When you see something like that, I know y'all probably don't care, but cut off the antenna so it looks better than it did before. Because before, it was looking ugs, man. But yeah, cut off my antenna.
She's looking better now. But anyway, let's go to the basketball court, man. I'm bored.
It is. It is sunny as hell.
Basketball changed my life. It gave me a sense of escape. When I'm on the court, nothing else matters. It's just me, the ball, and the sound of the net.
Bit the ball.
So y'all saw how I was looking at him when he was riding by close to him. I'm from Brooklyn. I think I'm stupid. Riding by close to my with a bike. Would have took that shit. Just kidding. I'm riding.
This is my life. Whether I'm playing with friends or just dribbling by myself, basketball is really life. It's a way of living. If I could, I would be on the court all day. I remember the summer of 2016 at the NYSC in Brooklyn. Literally, from 6 a.m. to 10 p.m., I was playing ball. Come in, come.
I could seat you by the fire. Listen, listen, there's something I must confide. I know I said that it'd be fine. I know I made it look like it'd be alright, but I think I learned my lesson, and I'm not gonna let you out of my sight. You can call me killer, 'cause I'll bring you to the light.
I was trying to get used to shooting with more strength because I gained around 12 pounds in the last month and a half. So you can imagine how much extra strength goes into my shot. So trying to adjust that, it's a struggle. But I love the struggle. Videos to not only motivate myself but to motivate you guys. It's never too late. Go get your dream. I believe in you.